I don't, Jenny, because I believe people have dug in. And there are certain situations we see not going on in society, Skip. People are dug in. No matter what transpired, no matter what happens, how many times it happens, no matter what gets said, we're dug in. That's some people's guy, and this is the same situation. Michael Jordan is their guy, and they're not moving off that fence. LeBron James is their guy. They're not moving off that fence. And I don't have a problem with that, Skip. I just think the thing is that if you needed this, and for me, Skip, like I said, I grew up watching Michael Jordan. I have a lot of his shoes and things of that nature. But if you needed this documentary to remind you how good Michael Jordan is, well, I don't know where you've been, especially if you were old enough, you're my age or a little older, and saw Michael Jordan. I don't know where you've been, Skip. I don't need to see. I guess in 10 years from now, we're going to have a documentary to remind us how great Tom Brady was. I don't need to see that documentary, Skip. I witnessed it. I played against him, and then I followed basically his career over the last 15, 16, 17 years. So I know what he represents. Skip, I just think the thing is that it's just like anything, Skip. These new, you listen to these new rappers and the Baby and Lil Baby and Future. Oh, they better than Nas. They better than Jay-Z. They better than Biggie. No, stop. Stop. It's just they're new. They're fresh. And these other guys haven't put out anything in a long period of time. So let's stop this. And I just think the thing is, Skip, if LeBron were to do a documentary, let's just say in 15 years, hey, if Kobe does a documentary, say, Skip, in the next decade, hell, people gonna think, man, Kobe, I don't know, Skip. Man, Kobe might be the GOAT. Kobe might be the GOAT. And then LeBron follows that up, and then it's gonna be another cycle. I love this, Skip, because we're always gonna have something to debate. As long as we have something to debate, you and I will be gainfully employed.
By the way, in your rapper analogy, you failed to mention the GOAT, Lil Wayne, so I will just off your analogy. Yes. Thank you very much.
Yeah, but that's the thing, Skip. People forget because, you know, well, Wayne just dropped the album and, you know, he's on Luda. He and Luda got something coming out. But, Skip, you know how it is, Skip. I mean, it's like we haven't seen you. Okay, so out of sight, out of mind.
Okay. Shannon, I have bad news for you. This Last Dance documentary was your last dance with your argument that LeBron is the GOAT. It's over. Now your GOAT mask that you often wear on Undisputed, you can wear it only on Halloween. Only on Halloween can you wear the GOAT mask. Or maybe if you happen to go back to your hometown in rural South Georgia, you can wear it out on the farm. You can wear your GOAT mask. But you cannot wear it anymore on national TV, on Undisputed, because LeShannon, I got really, really bad news. This ended the debate. It's over. And I believe that billions of what I call blind witnesses out there had their eyes opened by this documentary. Maybe they're too young to have seen Jordan in all his glory. Mm-hmm. I think now it's going to have a muting effect on their social media presence. I think they're going to be a lot quieter because in their heart of hearts, they now know what they just saw. And they know that force of nature in The Last Dance is above and beyond anything LeBron has ever been. I believe that those blind witnesses witnessed a cold-blooded killer and leader beyond anything we've ever quite seen from your man, LeBron James. I believe that they witnessed athleticism, quickness, acrobatics, quickness of jump, spring, explosion that we've just never quite seen from LeBron James. I believe they witnessed the greatest mid-range jump shooter we have ever seen, case closed, and that's always been LeBron's weakness. He has no real mid-range jump shot game. For that matter, he's a poor free throw shooter on top of that. I believe they witnessed behind the scenes what a force of nature leader motivator that he was in ways LeBron's not capable of being. I've always told you, LeBron's almost too nice of a guy, and I think everybody knows that. I think he's a fine guy off the floor, but he doesn't have enough of that killer will, that psycho drive in him that drove Jordan. So in the end, Shannon, I'm sorry that it makes you step back from LeBron's career and say, wait a second, Jordan was never accused by his owner of quitting in a series against the Celtics, a playoff series. He was never accused of melting down. Well, did it ever happen to Michael Jordan? Did Reinsdorf ever say he quit? No. I mean, it's unthinkable. And it's unthinkable that Michael would melt down in an NBA Finals, that one against the Dallas Mavericks. Chosen one becomes the frozen one. And finally, it's unthinkable that Michael Jordan would miss a final saving shot and that his legacy would be saved by Ray Allen from the corner on a long rebound to Chris Bosh. It's just unthinkable. And it disqualifies LeBron because it forces all of us to sit back and say, the truth is, it's not even close.
Skip, but here's the thing. We saw throughout this documentary that Michael Jordan missed last-second shots in finals games, in playoff games. And we saw Steve Kerr, we saw John Paxson hit shots, and nobody's ever said they saved their career. Nobody said metal world peace on that three-point shot in Game 7 saved Kobe's career. It's only LeBron. When he has a teammate, now Michael Jordan teammates step up, make plays when what they should do, that was Michael. See, that was Michael's leadership that forced them to make those shots and the ball went in. LeBron does the same thing and Ray Allen saved his career. And this one saved his career. Nobody else's career has gotten saved by a teammate, only LeBron. That's what's so frustrating for me is that, and you just said, Michael Jordan got duped. How does Michael Jordan, the guy that's mentally tough, the Jedi mind trick master, how does he get duped by Phil Jackson? So now what, either Michael Jordan is not as strong mentally as you would have us to believe, or you're not telling the truth that Phil Jackson is responsible why this broke up. What's one or the other?
No, I you know this. We all have our little weakness. We all have strong intelligence over here and weakness over
Michael
here.
Michael Jordan had no weakness.
One fatal flaw. Nope. He bought into Phil's phony baloney. That was the only weakness I ever saw in him. Only one.
Skip, I think the thing is what made Phil so unique is that you must be able to convince the strongest guy, your best player, to buy in. And that's what he would do. That's what he could do better than any other coach that coached Michael and Scottie. And that's why they were able to do it. That's what he was better to do with Shaq and Kobe. No one else could tap into that, get these guys to buy in and be one. He was able to do that. So whether you could say it was Finn, whether you say it was a bunch of bull job, or whatever the case may be, burning poetry and coffee cans, I don't know what it was, but it worked. So now I just need to know, was Michael Jordan as mentally strong as you said he was? Because
yes,
if he was. There's
yep.
no way
he was
Phil could have ran
of the team.
Okay. No, okay then. No. Okay. So.
Okay. So now here's the point. All those shots by little Stevie Kerr and little John Paxson, they weren't do or die shots. They weren't have to make it shots like Ray Allen's. If Ray Allen's shot doesn't go in, if it lips out, the way Jordan's did at the end of game four at Indiana. If it lips, we're having a whole different discussion because LeBron's 2-7 in NBA Finals. And what did Dennis Rodman say? Heck, what did Scottie Pippen say when Jordan stole the ball from Karl Malone at the end of game six at Utah in the finals in 98? Dennis Rodman said, I knew that, you know what, he's just going to shoot it. We don't know if LeBron's going to shoot it. He might pass it to George Hill. He might pass it to Kyle Korver in the corner. This one is get out of my way and let me do what I do. This is do or die. We are down one with whatever it was, 7 seconds left. I'm going to do it. Jordan had scored 45 points in that game in 44 minutes. The rest of the Bulls wound up scoring 42 total points in that game. Scotty obviously was sick and or had some back flare up where he had a back spasm. Back. Mm-hmm. So the point was, mm-hmm. you saw what Jordan did. LeBron just wouldn't do that. LeBron had that same situation at the end of game one. He had the Warriors dead to rights in their home arena with little Steph switched onto him at 6'3". Just go up and hold the pose, LeBron, and win the game. Nope, I got to kick it to George Hill so he can get fouled and go miss a free throw. Way to go, LeBron.
Oh, wow. Wow. Who'd have thought that an NBA player could miss a free throw? Wow. I mean, wow, George Hill. But that's my only problem, Skip, is that whatever Jordan did was right. If God missed the shot, well, he made the right play, that's Michael Jordan. LeBron James, well, Michael would have took that shot. No, he didn't, because Steve Kerr took a shot. John Paxson took a shot. Luke Longley took a shot. Bill Weddington dunked the ball. So stop this notion. Skip, stop this with this.